Oh my goodness. Sorry, I just got through watching that debate, the last part especially, and I saw this one clip of Hillary Clinton. Well, first, Donald Trump, he was going into this second debate, and people were talking about how he should step down. He had the typical Republicans running for the hills as usual. And, you know, of course, there's this whole thing over this audio tape he had. And he actually brings some of Bill Clinton's alleged victims to the debate. I mean, to the city, to St. Louis. And it creates a whole stir. Anyway, he finally admitted that he wasn't paying taxes for a certain amount of time. He also went into, he also addressed the issue of the audio tape. But I gotta tell you, the one thing that really stuck out in my mind was a part where Hillary Clinton was talking about the criminal justice system in this country. You know, like, she's giving this snarky comment about, you know, it's a good thing like people like Donald Trump aren't running this country's criminal justice system. And he responds with, because you'll be in jail. Sorry. I mean, it wasn't just what he said. It was his timing and the way he said it. Sorry. This definitely isn't Mitt Romney running for president. I'm sorry. It was just perfect the way he said it. And it's like, she should have known. They going to say, mention anything about the criminal justice system with her recent past was a bad move on her part. I don't know. I mean, that's the part I remember most about this debate. Oh man, it was just so brutal. Because the second best part was when Anderson Cooper stepped in and said, "Can you please not say anything?" Because as soon as Donald Trump said that, the crowd just went crazy. Wow, people started clapping and applauding, and they weren't supposed to do that. And then Anderson Cooper, he steps in and he says, please don't do that, you're just wasting time. And it's like, okay, really? We're wasting a whole 3 seconds laughing and applauding. I mean, his bias was so clear and it's so funny, man. It's just so pathetic. His anchors, the moderators, are so pissed when he said that. Oh my God. I mean, just brutal and hardcore. They didn't hold anything back. Oddly enough, somebody asked them, one guy asked them at the end, name one characteristic that you like about the other person, and one good thing you say about the other person. And Hillary, she didn't really answer the question. She said it was Donald's family, but interesting enough, Donald Trump answered the question and said that she never really quits. And it seemed a lot more genuine to me. I don't know, in a weird way, he sort of won that exchange right there. I usually don't get into political debates because presidential debates are never really true political debates. I mean, there's some other type of event. But yeah, I thought Donald Trump was going to be a wreck. It's going to be a complete disaster, but I was wrong. He took me by surprise. He definitely prepared for this one. And, interesting. That's all I gotta say. It's interesting. I will look forward to the day that this political season is over with, but it's so great just to see somebody call somebody out on TV. She needs to be called out. No, she needs to be called out. The bottom line is she broke the law, and if I would have did any half of what she did, deleting 33,000 emails or whatever, I would have went right to prison. I mean, that's just a fact of the matter. And I see people get away with things all the time simply because they come from a certain type of family. They have a certain type of background. They get all these second chances. They get all this free stuff. I see it all the time in society. That's why when I see somebody like Hillary Clinton able to break the law over and over again and just basically compromise national security and just do it so smugly, just feel like they're just above the law and everything, it just pisses me off. Anyway, guys, share your thoughts about this debate. Do you even care? What was the most memorable moment for you guys? Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Definitely not those who would be in jail.